Ernest Orlando Lawrence was not just the founder of our lab. He was a visionary who showed that scientists from different fields could work together to solve big, difficult problems, an idea that later became our national labs. Here's what you need to know about the gifted physicist behind Berkeley Lab and our ethos of team science. Lawrence was born in South Dakota in 1901 to a family of Norwegian-American teachers. Lawrence did not stand out as an exceptional student when he was younger, but his skill for engineering and building new devices was readily apparent. He began tinkering with electronics when he was just 8 years old. In college, he began to pursue his original goal of becoming a doctor. But the dean of the electrical engineering school saw Lawrence's astonishing self-taught radio building skills and realized the genius waiting within. The dean dared him to try just a semester in physics. And that was that. Lawrence was hooked. He went on to get a PhD in electromagnetic theory, which he completed at Yale. The physics community soon took note of the newly minted Dr. Lawrence's outstanding experimental skills and impressive research on the ionizing potential of electrons. He was courted by the University of California at Berkeley's physics department and joined as an assistant professor at just 27 years old in 1928. At Berkeley, he invented the cyclotron, a powerful yet compact particle accelerator that allowed scientists to study nuclear physics like never before. Other physicists were eager to join Lawrence's team to conduct experiments with cyclotrons, and thus the Radiation Laboratory, or Rad Lab, was born. Together, the Rad Lab group developed larger particle accelerators and other technologies that expanded our understanding of physics and enabled the discovery of new elements and the development of radiation therapy for disease. During this same period, in 1939, Lawrence received the Nobel Prize for the development of the cyclotron. Needing space and resources to build more powerful, cutting-edge devices, Lawrence successfully convinced the post-Depression government to invest in a new lab on the hills above the University of California campus in 1940. To staff the ambitious projects, he recruited more colleagues from around the world, drawing some of the brightest minds to California. This site has been active ever since, and now it's called Lawrence Berkeley National Laboratory. In 1941, Lawrence and his contemporaries were enlisted to work on wartime research efforts, including the Manhattan Project. After the war, Lawrence continued campaigning for government funding of the big science approach he had championed. He died in 1958 at age 57, but his legacy continues at Berkeley Lab through our multidisciplinary research on clean energy, healthy earth systems, and discovery science.